time is up. The Honourable Member for London Fanshawe.
Thank you, Madam Speaker. Last spring, I asked the Minister about the infrastructure bank and the fact that it would result in user fees and tolls on Canadians. It's an important issue for a vast majority of Canadians who deserve a real answer. I hope the Liberals will, despite previous practice, be honest with the people they serve, just as they promised when they came to power. The 2017 budget, as well as this fall's economic statement, represented great opportunities for the government to build an economy that benefits everyone, not just the wealthiest. Sadly, the Liberals did quite the opposite in both cases. Despite sunny ways, it appears that this government remains focused on using governance as a means to increase the wealth of its friends at the expense of hardworking Canadians. Where is the promise to be transparent and accountable? Madam Speaker, the Infrastructure Bank proves on several fronts that the Liberals can't keep their word. The Infrastructure Bank project was included in an omnibus bill about 300 pages long. I recall the Liberal promise during the last election campaign to abolish the use of undemocratic omnibus bills they vigorously denounced while the Harper government was in power. Can the minister explain why the use of such undemocratic practices has suddenly become acceptable? Secondly, in 2015, the Liberals promised that the Canada Infrastructure Bank would provide low-cost financing for new infrastructure programs. 1 year later, we learned that the Infrastructure Bank will be largely financed by private sector investors, investors who will demand significant returns on that investment. Projects funded under the infrastructure banks will have to produce revenues, notably by imposing user fees, tolls, and other new costs to citizens throughout Canada. I don't recall the Liberals being transparent about tolls at the time that the legislation was introduced. The bottom line is that Canadian taxpayers will be funding private corporations for public services. The infrastructure bank represents nothing less than the privatization of our infrastructure, privatization which benefits wealthy investors at the expense of hardworking Canadians who rely on public services. Madam Speaker, it raises the vital question of whether public services would be deemed unessential if they don't meet an acceptable profit margin for infrastructure bank investors. For example, would the public safety of rural areas and impoverished regions be overlooked because it wouldn't generate enough profit? Once again, profit appears to trump the public good in the Sunny Ways rulebook. The NDP has been very vocal in its opposition to the infrastructure bank. It doesn't serve the needs of Canadians. This privatization is disastrous for all of us. Infrastructure should firstly benefit all Canadians, including workers and families, not the financial elite and corporate friends of the Liberals. And we should most certainly not be double billing Canadians with additional user fees and tolls for essential infrastructure that they've already paid for with their tax dollars. Earlier this month, a report from the Columbia Institute, echoed by Canada's Information Commissioner, argued that Bill 44, passed in June, will further undermine the public's ability to access information about the infrastructure bank. The report clearly states that private sector interests are given a veto over releasing information about how public money is spent. It's clear that nothing has improved since I first asked my question in May. In fact, it looks worse than ever, Madam Speaker. The Honourable